Hello everyone and welcome back to the cooking stories. In this video we'll be seeing how to make a famous Bengali delicacy rose malai sandwich. So let's begin with the recipe. Bring 1.5 liters of full fat milk to a boil. Keep stirring in between. And once the milk comes to a boil, add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of vinegar to the milk to curdle it. So we are going to make chenna out of this milk. If you do not have vinegar, you can go for lemon juice. So add a little at a time, mix for 2 minutes and then add more if required. The milk has curdled and it will look like this once curdled. Now add 1.5 cups of cold water in order to prevent further cooking of the chenna, and strain the chenna immediately with the help of a sieve. Use a thin cloth to strain the chenna. Now I'm straining the curdled milk a little at a time. Discard the water and strain again. Now it's time to wash the chenna with some more cold water in order to remove the sourness of the vinegar. So I have used 1.5 cups of cold water to wash the chenna. So add the water and mix with a spoon so that the chenna is washed thoroughly. And now squeeze out 90% of the water from the chenna. Do not over squeeze because we are not looking for a very dry chenna here. So once the water is squeezed out, tie the cloth and keep it aside like this for about 15 to 20 minutes. And after 15 to 20 minutes, you will see that the chenna is ready. Take it out in a plate and now it is time to knead it smooth. So this chenna is now grainy in texture. Using your hand, knead it until it is nice and smooth. After kneading for about 3 to 4 minutes, this is how the chenna would look like. The texture should be like this. Now take small portions of the chenna and give them the shape of rectangular rasgullas. So Malai sandwiches are usually rectangular in shape. That is why I am giving them this shape. You can shape them the way you like. So make equal sized rectangular rasgullas out of all the chenna. These rasgullas should be crack free. Now heat 5 cups of water and add 1.5 cups of sugar to the water. We are going to make sugar syrup. The sugar syrup has come to a boil and now add in the rasgullas into the sugar syrup. Using the back of your spoon, push the rasgullas a little bit into the sugar syrup and cover and cook them for about 7 to 8 minutes on medium flame. It has been 8 minutes and the rasgullas have cooked and almost doubled in size. At this stage, switch off the flame and do not do anything to them. Just cover them and let them cool down. Do not try to separate the rasgullas or pick them up when they are hot. You may end up breaking them. Let us move on to making the stuffing of our Malai sandwiches. So heat a pan and add 150 grams of mawa or khoya to the pan. In Marathi, we also call it as khawa. Now cook this khoya for about 2 minutes. Add in 2 tablespoons of sugar. If you prefer more sweet, you can add 3 tablespoons. 1 teaspoon of rose essence. 2 tablespoons of chopped pistachios and 2 drops of pink food color. You can add dry fruits of your choice. Now saute and cook this mixture for about 2 minutes more. The stuffing is ready. Take it out in a plate and let it cool down completely. The rasgullas have cooled down and now it is time to get rid of the excess sugar syrup. So place them in a sieve as shown. Do not squeeze them. We only want to get rid of the excess syrup. And now let us begin with the assembly of our rose malai sandwiches. So here I have the stuffing that we have prepared. It has thickened as it has cooled down now. Take a rasgulla and slice it from the middle as shown. Look at the texture of our spongy rasgullas. Similarly, slice all the other rasgullas. Now take the sliced rasgullas and place about 1 tablespoon of the stuffing into each sandwich. So press it properly, give it the shape, and then close it with the upper layer, and our rose malai sandwich is ready. Similarly, repeat the process for all the other rasgullas. Now it's time for some garnishing. So here I have edible gold foil, which I'm putting on top of each malai sandwich. This is optional. You can also use silver foil or varak. Now add in some finely chopped pistachios or dry fruits of your choice. With this, super delicious rose malai sandwiches are ready. Believe me, they taste awesome. Do give this recipe a try, and also let me know in the comment section what other recipes you want me to make. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye-bye.